In this video, I'm going to talk about what is exponential functions and how does the graph of exponential function look like, and then how to use transformation to get an exponential function, starting from an exponential function and get a complicated exponential function, okay? So the first of all, any function of this form, c times a to the x, where a is positive, and basically c is constant, okay, it's called exponential function. So what is basically, how do we know a function is exponential? So the basic idea is, if x is in the exponent and if there is a positive number in the base, then it is called exponential function. So this constant can be anything, it can be positive, negative, or any number, okay, but the base must be positive and there must be x in the exponent, then this type of function is called exponential function. If you want to see some examples, for example, say f of x equals to say 2 to the x, or f of x equals to say 3 times 2 to the x, so these are exponential function, right? So, or you can say g of x equals to 10 negative 10 times 3 to the twice x. So this is also exponential function, right? In all cases, x is in the exponent. Let me give you one more example. That is f of x equals to e to the x. What is e though? E is a number, so e is almost equal to 2.718, and then it is an irrational number, right? So e is an irrational number whose value is almost equal to 2.718. if there is a, so e is positive number, right? If there is x in the exponent, this is also exponential function, okay? Now we want to see how does the graph of exponential function look like. So let's take an example. So y equals to 2 to the x. Now how do I draw the graph of y equals 2 to the x from scratch? Okay, the first thing we want to do is we want to make a chart and take different values of x and then get the values of y. Let me take x equals to 0. What do you get? You will get 2 to the 0. So for a number, if the exponent is 0, then the value is 1. So when x is 0, y is 1. When x is 1, y is 2 to the 1, that is 2, right? When x is negative 1, what do you get? 2 to the negative 1, right? 2 to the negative 1 means, so 1 half, right? 2 to the negative 1 means like, it will be 2 to the negative 1, and if you want to write that, it will be 1 half. So it will look like this. So 2 to the negative 1 is 1 half. So if you take negative 1 for x, it will be 2 to the negative 1, that will be 1 half, that will be 0.5. Okay? If you take x equals to 2 though, what do you get? For x equals 2, you will get 2 to the 2, that is 2 to the square, right? So that is 4. But if you take x equals negative 2, it will get 2 to the negative 1 there. Negative 2 for x equals negative 2. So that will be 1 over 2 to the square. That is 1 fourth, right? 1 fourth means 0.25. So 0.25. That's what you will get. Okay? Let's plug in these points. So you continue taking these values of x and getting values of y, but if you plug in there, so at x equals to 0, you will get 1. That is 1 point. At x equals to 1, you will get 2. You will get that. At x equals to negative 1, you will get 0.5. That is the half of that, somewhere here. Right? At x equals 2, you will get 4. Somewhere here. X equals negative 2, you'll get 0.25, half of that, even half of that. And it continues that way, okay? So if you draw the graph, you will see the graph of y equals 2 to the x like this. Okay? So what did you see from the graph? So y equals 2 to the x is always above x-axis, okay? And you can see that x-axis is a horizontal asymptote of this graph. Also, the graph is always increasing function. When you go to the right, you will get the higher values of y. It is increasing function. But tell me the domain and range of y equals 2 to the x. So what is the domain of exponential function? So the graph is always like above x-axis. If the number on the front is like, basically the c here is 1. If you compare that with c a to the x, c is 1. If c is positive, it is always above x-axis. If c is negative, it will be below x-axis though. Okay, in this case, so what is the domain then? So domain is the values of x, right? So domain is, what are the possible values of x in this function or in this graph? So it can go to negative infinity to positive infinity. You can go and you can take any value of x, meaning that, so from negative infinity to infinity. And what is the range of this? So range is, what are the values of y? So it never cross x-axis, right? So it will never go below x-axis. So it will be 0 to infinity. So it is, because the graph is always above x-axis and it never touch x-axis, that's why we have a parenthesis there. Okay, so this is how we find the domain and range of the exponential function. All right, so I mean, you can plot this in graph, this graph in calculator, and then see what are the possible values of x and y from the graph too. You can guess what are the domain and range. So usually if c is positive, then the domain is negative infinity to infinity and range is 0 to infinity. But if c is negative, then the domain is the same, negative infinity to infinity, but range will be negative infinity to 0, because the graph will be below x-axis in that case. Okay, let's take another example. Starting from the graph of fx equals to 2 to the x, write the steps to obtain the graph of fx equals to 1 half 2 to the x minus 3 plus 4. Okay, so what we do is we start from 2 to the x and we're going to get x minus 3, and then you're going to get times 1 half, and then you're going to get plus 4. So what is the next step you do? You do shift right by 3 units, right? So what do you get? The equation will be y equals to 2 to the x minus 3. This is the shift right by 3 units, okay? Then what? So you're going to get 1 half. So vertical stretch, vertical compression, basically, because it is less than 1, compression with factor 1 half. How does that look like? So the equation will be y equals to 1 half 2 to the x minus 3. You multiply the right hand side by that factor, okay? And then what next? I want to get plus 4, right? So vertical shift, meaning shift up, you can write vertical shift up by 4 units, right? So what do you get? What is the final equation you get? Number 4 is y equals to 1 half 2 to the x minus 3 plus 4. So this is what you, these are the steps that you will get when you start from 2 to the x, and then if you want to get the graph of that. How does the graph look like? Let's start from, this is y equals 2 to the x, right? And the first you did shift right by 3 units. So you will shift right by 3 units like that. So this will be like that, right? And then vertical compression by 1 half. That means you will compress vertically by 1 half. So it will look like more flat, right? And then shift up by 4 units. So the final graph will look like this. Right? Because it will be shifting up by 4 units. All right, guys. Thank you.